So Urgent 11 is a set of 11 vulnerabilities that were discovered in VxWorks, which is the real-time operating system made by Wind River Systems. All of the vulnerabilities were associated with the TCP IP stack, and basically they ranged from something as simple as denial of service to something as problematic as remote code execution. They were all associated, some of the fields in the TCP IP stack have basically a length field, and that length field could be mishandled to create some pretty critical implications such as remote code execution. The reason Urgent 11 is so important is because it is a real-time operating system used in many, many devices around the world, including many of those in the operational technology space, such as oil and gas and electric utilities. The most important aspect of starting to address the impact of the vulnerabilities is to actually gain visibility into your own network, so you know how many devices that you have on your network already have those visibility. So for customers that have the continuous threat detection, they would already have that information, they would know what devices they have, and then we match that with the existing vulnerabilities and we get a pretty good understanding of the risks. We of course have signatures that are addressing some of those vulnerabilities, and also we have indicators of compromise outside of the signatures that help with the detection capabilities as well. Of course, customers are also advised to use technical compensating controls, such as virtual zones. Virtual zones help you to put devices into different zones and specify a policy of what communication needs to happen between those zones. So that's another very convenient way of detecting potential exploitation of those vulnerabilities. There are currently a lot of technologies that can actually help with the challenges in OT cybersecurity. But of course, as everything else, we have to start with the humans. So number one, I would say for an organization to be successful, they must have one owner that is actually responsible for securing of the OT and the IoT components. And that of course must come with clear budget expectations. The second component to that is, I said it before, I said it again, it's the visibility. You actually need to know what you have in your networks and be able to identify all of the devices that are currently unknown. That in turn will allow you to exactly calculate what is the risk associated with those networks that you have, and that will help you to prioritize. We have the tendency to want to go and address everything once we see the results of a survey and an assessment, but it's extremely important to prioritize and to deploy technical compensating controls in ways where we cannot directly address the problem. For example, patching is one of those very problematic areas. So get the person and the budget allocated, get visibility into your networks, and then prioritize with the items that you can do immediately so that we don't get lost into the perfection game.